Welcome students to this exclusive webinar by Professor Jaiteet Rao, popularly known as Jerry Rao, and he'll be addressing you on a very, very interesting subject, which is in everybody's mind, global economic scenario post-COVID era. Professor Rao is distinguished alumnus of University of Chicago, IIM Ahmedabad, and Loyola College, Chennai. He is an Indian businessman, an entrepreneur who founded several companies like Emphasis, Value and Budget Housing Corporation, VBHC, and Home First Finance Company, HFFC. He held several positions in Citibank prior to his founding Emphasis in 1998. In a banking career spanning over 20 years, he served with Citi and its parent, Citicorp, in various capacities in Asia, Europe, South America, and North America. He was head of the development division of Citicorp and chairman and CEO of Transaction Technology based in California. He teaches at IIM Ahmedabad, IIT Bombay, LIBA Chennai, and also at Fostheimer Business School. He has been entrepreneur in residence at Harvard Business School. He has been on the boards of several companies, including Royal Orchard Hotels, Infrastructure Development, Private Equity, etc. So over to you, Jerry.
Thank you, Sunil.
Yep.
It's a pleasure and a privilege to talk to young students planning to enter business school. It's also a challenge at a time like this, because everything you see on TV or on social media or everywhere else and in our own lives is nothing but this mahamari, as our prime minister calls it, this great disease, COVID. So when these challenges happen, it's important to step back and think about what it means for the future careers of people like you. And I was just thinking back about my own career. 73, the year that all of us graduated from IIM Ahmedabad, was the year of the Yom Kippur War between Israel and the Arabs, and the year of the first increase in oil prices. Before that, oil was a fairly unimportant commodity. It also made countries like Saudi Arabia the richest countries in the world. That all happened in 73 and beyond. I've been thinking of other times, 75 to 77. Most of us were working in India. We went through a political emergency. It was the only time in my life I used to do a lot of negotiations with our labor union, when our labor union used to be scared of us. Usually it was the other way around. But during the emergency, they were. Then one has seen so many different times. 91, 92, India almost went bankrupt. We had less than $2 billion in reserves. To give you an idea, right now we have about $500 billion. At that time, we had only $2 billion. And it was eroding every day by 100, 200 million. I remember meeting the then RBI governor, Venkat Ramanan, and talking about the crisis and how to deal with the crisis. But we came out of it and India emerged stronger. Then in more recent times, times that when you people were in high school probably, or maybe even a little earlier, in 2008, we saw a great financial crisis. There have been many other smaller crises, like in 2000, there was a dot-com bust and so on. In 79, there was another oil crisis, an increase in oil prices. So these things have happened at various times. The 2008 was a pretty bad one because one of the biggest banks in the world went bankrupt, Lehman Brothers, and several other banks and financial institutions, Merrill Lynch, Wachovia, Washington Mutual, all disappeared. They were acquired. Unka naam hi badal gaya. Chalega. There is no Wachovia today. There is no Washington Mutual. Ye sab 100 saal ke purane, old, excellent financial institutions they were. Northern Trust in England. So we really saw a very strange situation when the world financial markets basically collapsed. For a few days, there was no trading on New York Stock Exchange, derivatives, this, that. It was quite strange. In between, by the way, there was another political crisis, 9/11, that was in 2001, when some terrorists attacked the World Trade Center in New York. Actually, I was watching it on TV. The first building had come down and somebody called me. And then I switched on the TV. So I watched this second building coming down live. And that created a whole set of wars and all kinds of problems and continued terrorism around the world, which still hasn't gone away. So I was just thinking in preparing my talk to you people that in 39 years that I've been talking about, there have been many crises of different kinds, oil price increases twice, financial crisis twice, political crisis in India a couple of times, economic crisis in India a couple of times, political crisis globally a couple of times. So it's not as if life is always smooth. Now, let us look at the similarities and differences between those other crises and COVID. Similarity, it's a global crisis. Like 73 was a global crisis, 9/11 was a global crisis, 2008 was a global crisis. That's a similarity. The difference, the big difference is that this seems like a natural crisis. Those were all political and financial crises, which in some sense happened because of the failures of human institutions. A bank failed, a market failed. The political discussion between Islamic radicals and America failed. That created 9/11. So there were failures in politics and financial institutions, which led to the crises. Here, it seems like it's natural, although there is some debate about that. Some people believe that this might be a man-made virus from a Chinese laboratory. Whether it was deliberately released or accidentally released, we are not sure. Although most people feel, even if it was man-made, it was accidentally released. So it's a kind of an accidental thing. That is the first thing about this crisis that makes it different. The second thing about this crisis that makes it different is that it is one where we cannot respond with simple human responses. You can't say, let me reduce interest rate, let me increase taxes, let me do something like that, which is what we do normally when there's a financial crisis and the government tries to solve it. This virus is mutating and things like that, so it's not very clear we can give simple human responses. How then should we approach this? How then should you people, young people, at your age, as you're starting your MBA program, how should you be approaching this? And are there any places you can go to look for answers, for insights, for suggestions? Kahan jaake dhoonde, jahan kuch sawalon ka jawab milega? That's the real question that you are faced with. And frankly, if right now, today, one of your family members is not well, your uncle or aunt or your parents or somebody or your neighbor, you're only worried about that and you're not in a mood to think about other matters. I would argue with you that is in fact the time to think about the bigger picture. The disease is there, it is not going to go away easily. It is going to create trouble for all of us. But look at the bigger picture. Smallpox has been with us, to our knowledge, for 7,000 years. From 5,000 BC, we have evidence of skeletons of bodies which had smallpox. Finally, it was eradicated only in the 1980s. It took 7,000 years. The first vaccination took, 6,700 years. 1700s may, Jenner did the first vaccination. And the final eradication took 7,000 years. So it took a long time to make a smallpox vaccination. Here, I know everybody criticizes Trump, but Trump announced last year in May, "Dekho, by January, hum vaccine bana denge." And yes, the fact is, ban gaya by January. Everybody made fun of him at that time, ki isko kuch nahi maloom, bewakoof hai, aise hi baat karta hai. But the fact of the matter is, think of this bigger picture. While we do, today we have a problem. There's an oxygen short supply. There is hospital beds are not there. So there's an immediate crisis. But think that when in past times, when human beings took hundreds of years, thousands of years to solve problems, here we were able to solve a problem in 6 months. And in the next 6 months, therefore 18 months after Mr. Trump's speech, the whole world will be vaccinated. 18 months kaha hai, 6,700 years kaha hai. We have to look at that difference. So I think while it is a worrisome situation, if you step back, and you should step back, don't say, no, I can't step back. I have to worry only about today. You have to worry about today and you have to worry about the big picture. You have to do both. It is not an either or. It is what I called an and. Ye bhi karna hai, wo bhi karna. You cannot say, I'm sirf yehi karenge. So when you're doing both things, there are some areas that I want to draw your attention to, because Mr. Somani has specifically asked me to speak about the global economy and what I expect. Now, of course, global economy, as you all know, nobody can correctly predict, even if you're the best Jyotishi in the world. So I am going to try and give you directions, give you ideas about where we are headed. The idea is not to predict exactly inflation 5.2% hoega, growth 7.1% hoega, unemployment ye hoega. No, that's not my plan. My plan is to give you some directional ideas. Particularly, I think it's important for you. You're joining a business school. You have to decide which courses you want to put your attention in. Accounting pe zyada attention karenge ki marketing pe. These are decisions you have to take. And you have to figure out how you will plan your career. Whom will you get advice from? How will you manage your learning, your training situation, so that you're best prepared for the world in 2 years. So it's also a very specific problem for you. It's not simply generally gyan ki economy kaise rahega, how will it impact people like you? So that's the trend of thought that I'm trying to explore. The amazing thing is, if you go back and look at data, and we have fairly good data going back to the 1880s. सो 140 इयर्स ऑफ डेटा हमारे पास है. जनरली व्हेन द स्टॉक मार्केट इज स्ट्रॉन्ग द नेक्स्ट 2-3 इयर्स द इकोनॉमी इज स्ट्रॉन्ग. एंड द फनीएस्ट थिंग इज अंडर कोविड, ऑफ कोर्स इन फेब्रुवरी मार्च 2020 the stock market took a beating when first COVID was announced. After that, global stock markets, American stock market, Indian stock market, they have all been extremely strong and they continue to be strong. There are some minor adjustments. This week there has been a small adjustment in India. But in general, it is amazing. You would think at a time when there is so much unemployment, some log Bombay, Delhi, chhodke, they are going back to their villages. There is so much gadbad, so many restaurants closed, so many shopping malls closed. You would think that the stock market would be weak. It's not. Which means what the stock market is saying is 2022, 2023, 2024, 2025, those years are going to be years of tremendous economic growth. Which means when you graduate from first IMA, at that time, all of you will get good jobs. The economy will be growing and you will be in a position to get good jobs. That's the important thing that you must be aware of. Okay. The other interesting thing is, now let us look at which aspects of the stock market are doing well. And that is another very funny kind of situation. The entire startup system in India in the last 18 months has done better than in the previous 18 years. The formation of new companies, the ability of new companies to raise capital, the ability of new companies to do well, and what we now call unicorns, the ability of new companies to establish valuations in excess of $1 billion quickly, all that in the last 18 months during COVID has been far superior to the previous 18 years. Or the previous 28 years, if you look at 1992 as the beginning of economic reform in India. So there is something happening here. There is a lot of capital and there is a lot of excitement. So while there is this problem that restaurants are closed and health clubs are closed and gyms are closed, and there's a problem of transportation and all that, there is also this other problem that startups are doing well. And which are the startups that are doing well? Financial technology startups are doing extremely well. By financial technology, I mean things like payments, phone pay, and companies like that. They are doing extremely well. Then data analytics companies are doing extremely well. Mu Sigma is a company which has, which is a unicorn, more than $1 billion in valuation. I think it's actually $3 billion in valuation. So people who are looking at data are doing very well. Of course, the big companies, Google, Amazon, are doing well. But it's not just the big companies. It's a whole number of companies which are in this digital space. This company, Squiggy, is doing very well. Zomato is doing very well. So a whole host of companies are doing extremely well in the digital space, in the financial technology space, in the analytics space. Does that mean traditional companies are not doing well? That's not true. Traditional banks are doing extremely well. HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, Axis Bank, Kotak Bank, they're all doing extremely well. Traditional companies are also doing very well in the financial sector. Pharma sector, though, they are doing outstandingly well. You know, it's just amazing. Dr. Reddy's or Torrent or any of these companies are doing brilliantly well. So then we have a unique situation that despite COVID, despite this Mahamari, as our Prime Minister calls it, the economy seems to be on relatively sound footing. And all the indicators for 2 years down the road, 18 months down the road, when you people graduate, look good. So this is the time when you should be investing your time, energy, and money, and your parents' money in education to make sure that you are ready when the good times that are anticipated are going to come. Another area that I am quite frankly surprised by is even those industries which are supposed to be in serious trouble, like airlines. If you look at it, there are two bidders for Air India. There are three bidders who want to buy Air India. You would think all the flights have been canceled, nobody is traveling, airline industry is in deep trouble, nobody would be buying. It's not true, because again, people are looking at the future. People are looking at the future. And the same thing is happening in two-wheelers. And the same thing is happening in automobiles. In automobiles, it's very interesting. The biggest challenge that in automobiles, both motorbike manufacturers and car manufacturers and truck manufacturers, they know electric vehicles are coming, but they also know for the next 3 to 5 years, they may not be coming. So you have to manage this dynamism. Abhi se banana shuru kar doge, to you will have a problem. Bahut postpone karoge, then you will have a problem. Kab tak banayenge internal combustion engine vehicles or kab se electrical, that challenge. So again, those are challenges that people like you, young managers, as you come out and start working in these companies, you will be faced with. And they are interesting challenges. So that is the other thing I want to say, COVID or no COVID, it is a good time to be an MBA. It is a good time to be a manager, especially 18 months, 2 years from now. It will be an excellent time to be an MBA, to be a manager, to be a management trainee, to be starting your career. So I'm talking about the global economy. Let me go back, because that's the subject. But I really don't want to talk only global, Gyan. I want to relate it to your lives. In the global economy, certain things are very interesting. One thing is interest rates have come down. In India, interest rates used to be 12%, 14%. Now they are 5%, 6%. In America, they used to be 6%, 7%. They are now 0%, 1%. So interest rates have come down everywhere. And central banks are determined to make sure that this crisis, they support all of us. If they keep interest rates high, then companies don't borrow. And then therefore economic activity doesn't take place. So they are determined to keep interest rates low. One of the advantages when interest rates are low is not only can companies borrow, governments also can borrow. We are now, 2 years ago, if you had asked me, I would have said, yaar, ye Hindustan government ka deficit bahut hi zyada hai, khatarnak hai, and so on. Now I am less worried, because government of India, instead of paying 7-8% interest, is paying 1-2% interest. If that is the case, they can borrow more. And I don't mind their borrowing, buying vaccinations, building roads, doing whatever they want to do. So this is the second thing that COVID has forced governments and countries to do, is to be liberal both with their private sector and with their government sector. And to keep interest rates low has actually helped this second thing happen. You cannot borrow if interest rates are high. Now, some people, those who are retired, those who live on Provident Fund, they will complain about low interest rates. But kya kare? It is better to have low interest rates than high interest rates. And everybody is agreed on that. And this is something that is happening globally. The second thing that is happening globally is this digital revolution is now COVID has completely forced on us. Now look at this whole session. I am sitting outside Bangalore and I'm doing a session with all of you. You are all sitting in your homes. Ye to pehle bhi kar sakte the, but nahi karte the. And this company Zoom was started by a fellow who used to work with Cisco. Cisco was the first company that created these software for having conferences. But Cisco was a little limited in their thinking. They thought all conferences company ke andar hi hoega, between company head office and branch office, and they created software for that. This fellow said, hey, wait a minute. There is an opportunity. And Zoom, by the way, is one of the companies with the highest market cap growths and highest profitabilities in the last 12 months. But what it has done is it has changed the way all of us operate. This Amazon home delivery of things, Squiggy home delivery of meals, all this has changed. My sister actually got COVID in Bangalore. This was some 10 days ago. You know, she never went to see the doctor. Everything was done by video call. One fellow came to our house to take her blood test and her nose test. And he wore the equipment and took it. And he did it once in the beginning of the disease and once in the end. Otherwise, everything done digitally, done remotely, done by video. In fact, she used to take her oxygen and show it like this. And the doctor at the other end, video camera, said, dekhta tha, Zoom pe. So what I'm saying is our lives have completely changed. My sister is also 75 years old. She is very devoted. Jyada puja wagera karti hai. Every day she is watching the Tirupati temple darshan on video for 1 hour. So she doesn't have to go to Tirupati. So what has happened is that COVID, these technologies existed 2 years ago. It's not that you could not take a video of a Tirupati puja 2 saal pehle. Wo tha. But we did not adopt it, embrace it as we have embraced it today. Anybody, Sunil, in an introduction, mentioned this housing company that I am associated with. Nowadays, 90% of our sales, we don't bother to advertise in newspapers or anywhere. Everything is digital marketing. And customer comes to the website, sees it. We have a 3D picture. He takes a tour on the website, even a house. Now, you can do that with books or clothes or something. But even something as concrete as a house, we have several people who have bought it without actually visiting it. You would never have believed it 18 months ago ki koi ghar khareedega dekhe bina, chue bina. What ho raha hai? That is the strangeness of this COVID, this mahamari has really altered. And therefore, you people, please spend your time the next 2 years making sure that your understanding of digital marketing, your understanding of analytics, your understanding of basic software associated with these things is very good. You don't have to be a software programmer, but you have to understand the usage of the software. And that, if you can do, I think you will be positioned for some extremely interesting things going forward. Because you're going to have, I mean, the number of Google Pay, Phone Pay. No, you don't Paytm. You just, it's amazing. I'm now staying in a place outside Bangalore, 3 hours outside in a small village. Every shop here has Paytm and Phone Pay and Google Pay in the village. It's amazing. So the idea that you have to go to a bank, stand in a branch, go and withdraw cash and then go to a shop, khatam hi ho gaya. So, and all these companies are the ones that will employ you and you will have an exciting career. That is my basic. Now, again, I'm doing this back and forth, big picture, gyan, and then how it affects you. The other really big picture gyan that we should all worry about is this China America quarrel. Isse kya hoga? Isse ye hoga, and ye 3 mahine mein nahi hoga, but over 5 years, you will find that Indonesia, India, Vietnam, Bangladesh, to some extent Sri Lanka, these are the countries that will benefit. Because whether you like it or not, people have lost confidence and faith in China. The fact is that everything we buy is from China. All the oximeters, by the way, that you may be using at home, that you put on your finger to look at oxygen concentration, 95% of them are made in China today. So today we are all buying Chinese equipment. Isme to koi doubt nahi hai. But over 5 years, ye kam ho jaye. And this is going to be for the benefit of India, Bangladesh, Vietnam, Indonesia, Philippines. These countries will benefit. And you will see that happening, whether you Chinese like it or not. They have done the biggest PR disaster in the history of public relations that I can know of. They have angered and insulted every country in the world. Sab unse naraaz hain. And this is not a good way to lead a life. I mean, if you go and make everybody in your family and in your class and in your group angry, what will happen? Nobody will talk to you. You may be a rich person, so for the first 2 months, they may still need you. But over time, they will all figure out ways that they don't need you. Hena? That is what is happening in this US-China thing. I am optimistic about the US. Many people are not, but I am. Because I can already see that, you know, one of the things that you have to understand, the difference between democratic systems and dictator systems, that dictator systems can be very efficient. You can make oximeters very efficiently. You can make some things very efficiently, which is what the Chinese do. But once you commit a mistake, you don't know how to correct it. As long as you're doing things right, a dictatorship is brilliant. But jab ek bhi galti ho jata hai, they don't know how to correct it. Whereas Americans run a democracy, India runs a democracy. Abhi galti ho gayi, immediately Modi calls a meeting and make some changes in the vaccination policy. There, it is impossible for Xi Jinping to ever admit openly ki meri galti ho gayi. He cannot change policy. He's a god. It would have been so simple for them in this pandemic. Yaar, galti ho gayi Wuhan mein. Please excuse us. Please help us. Let us be friends. People know such things can happen. Instead, they did some hera-feri, they suspended data, they were not transparent, they made everybody suspicious, everybody disliked them, nobody wants to use their vaccine, right? They have created this unnecessary, that is because Xi Jinping cannot do any wrong. Wo to devta hai. Whereas in democratic systems, however inefficient we may be, we are today inefficient. As you can say, we don't have enough oxygen. But in 2 weeks, that will change. We will have enough oxygen. Why? Because galti ko hum acknowledge karte hain, policy ko change karte hain, and then oxygen will be available in plenty. Just watch. In 2 weeks, there will be much more oxygen than we need. Aisa hi hoega. That is the way it will work. But in their case, अरे ऑक्सीजन का प्रॉब्लम है ही नहीं, दे विल नेवर एक्सेप्ट. एंड दैट इज व्हाई चाइना आई एम नॉट ऑप्टिमिस्टिक अबाउट. आई एम वेरी ऑप्टिमिस्टिक अबाउट अमेरिका. नाउ व्हाट डज दैट मीन फॉर अस? दैट मीन्स अगेन आई एम ट्राइंग टू डू द मैक्रो पिक्चर एंड देन व्हाट डज इट मीन फॉर यू. इट मीन्स दैट व्हेन यू ग्रेजुएट ऑल ऑफ दीस फेलोज विल बी ग्रोइंग इन इंडिया इन अ बिग वे. वॉलमार्ट, Amazon, all of them. And they will be acquiring Indian companies. Remember, Walmart acquired Flipkart. And it's very interesting, that acquisition. I don't know how many of you know. They paid a lot of money to acquire Flipkart. They never knew that Flipkart had a small subsidiary called PhonePe. It turns out today that PhonePe is more valuable than what Walmart paid for Flipkart. And they are taking that PhonePe technology all over the world, including to America. Unko pata hi nahi tha. Ye chota koi department tha, kisi ne dekha hi nahi tha. PhonePe, Flipkart ke andar. But that has turned out to be more valuable than Flipkart. So these things happen in business. And you will find, I think, therefore, India being strong, Indian economy being strong, Indo-US relations being strong. Is this going to be easy? Answer is no. Next 2-3 weeks will be very difficult. Next 2-3 months will be difficult. Next 6 months will be difficult. But 18 months from now, 24 months from now, when you come out with your degree, it's going to be looking good. Now, the other challenge that you are facing is, should you do only virtual education or should you do virtual plus physical education? Main aapko ek small point I want to make and then I will end this talk. Never go for any extreme. This idea that 100% virtual mein hi hum jee lenge is not a good idea. Ultimately, we are human beings. We are not machines. We are not robots. We need to hug each other. We need to see each other. We need to see each other's body language. We need to go and have dinner together. We need to sit in the canteen and have chai together. We need to sit in the class and look at a blackboard. We need to sit in the class and look at the way the professor walks up and down. And even in business, we need to have meetings where we see the other person, where we get together. So I'm not saying we should do 100%, 50, 60% of the time we can do virtual. But to make physical contact zero and virtual contact the only contact, I think is not smart. I think you will be less competent as managers if you do that. So in your own interest, in order to be good managers, emerge as good managers with good PGDM degrees. I am suggesting to you that you work with first timer, with your parents, with your friends to find a proper balance. The physical contact should not be completely given up. That will be a big mistake. And those who do it, bahut pachtayenge. Abhi nahi, 2 saal mein, 5 saal mein, 10 saal mein pachtayenge, because they will lose out some part of their education, training, development, which is central. Now with that, let me re-summarize. There have been many crises, oil crisis, 9/11, emergency. This is one more, this is a little different. In some ways it is similar, it is global, it's different because it's kind of natural and has mutations and so on. But it's amazing that in 7 months we have been able to create a vaccination. What would have taken 10 years earlier or 100 years earlier, 7 mahine mein kar diya hai. So it also tells you that we can respond as a human unit. There have been screw-ups. We've been overconfident in January, February. We thought mahamari chala gaya hai. It's come back, but this too shall pass. When you're going through it, it always sounds more difficult. But please take time to look at the bigger picture. Financial markets are strong, which means they are projecting that 1 year, 2 years from now, the economy will be good. And that's always been the case. Within financial markets, financial industry, banking industry, fintech, analytics, education, Byju's is getting more than $1 billion a valuation. And by the way, it's interesting. Everybody who says physical things doesn't matter, Byju's has bought a company which has physical classrooms, which does physical coaching centers. They're not stupid. They realize that you need digital and you need physical. So there's a whole host of industries. So when you graduate, you will be able to do well. Governments, central banks will continue to keep interest rates low. So business will do well. Government can also spend well. This US-China rift is actually going to help China, countries like India. More than India, it's actually going to help Vietnam and Bangladesh. But India also over the next 5 years. Not today, not immediately. But at the time when you graduate, you will start seeing the impact of this. You must focus on getting your skills in digital marketing, in analytics, in fintechs, in understanding software usage while you're doing your MBA. And please do a proper combination of both digital and physical. Ek hi cheez mat karo, acha nahi rahega. This is my fervent plea to you. I wish you all good luck. I will be teaching one of the courses that you will be taking, I hope. And at the end of 2 years, I hope all of you get great jobs and have great careers ahead. Good luck. Let me stop and take any questions you may have.
There's some questions in the Q&A. You can open that. There's just two questions.
Where are they? How do I open Q&A?
I can open it.
Chat. I open chat.
No, not chat. Q&A. There's a Q&A.
Ah, Q&A. I have opened. Okay.
These are more observations than anything. But anyway, you take them.
Shreyas Jaiswal says, respected sir, we can say that COVID situation has also opened new paths. All we have to do is turn adversity into opportunities. Absolutely, you're absolutely correct. Because if you think about it, I don't think Zomato would have got this valuation without COVID. COVID made Zomato. COVID made Zoom. So even adversity creates opportunities for some. Harshiva Singh Karbanda, sorry, sir, to interrupt, but being shortage of oxygen in India, whereas no other country faces it, while we all knew earlier the second wave has to come up, then as being an owner of a company, why companies doesn't look that opportunity to prepare earlier before the wave hit back? You know, frankly, I don't think anybody did know that it would be so bad. By March end, middle of March, even early April, it was not considered such a bad situation. And I think the people who really, if the hospitals had said, we want oxygen, there's plenty of oxygen available in this country. India is a large industrial country. Many people make oxygen. There's no shortage of oxygen in a physical sense. But even the hospitals, I remember talking to two doctors who said, yaar, we've got 500 COVID beds that are vacant. Kya kare? There are no patients. You know, so the whole country, not just the government, became complacent. Your point is, why didn't hospitals, some hospitals and oxygen companies see this opportunity? I think everybody failed. Sometimes collective failures happen. Online trading applications are also doing great. So we can take this as a career opportunity or not. If you want to join an online trading company, please do so. If you want to do online trading yourself, please be very careful. If your parents are very rich, then you can do it. Otherwise, please be very careful. The problem with online trading is it requires deep capital, lots of knowledge, lots of experience. So if you're thinking of doing it yourself, be careful. But if you want to join an online trading company, that's a great idea. That is Shubham Sharma. Next. Sir, which stream should I join in this situation or which? It's not completing, yaar. Kya ho raha?
No, he's saying, which stream should I join in this situation? It's like, should he go into marketing or finance or which do you think is the hot thing which meets with the future?
I think both marketing and finance, digital marketing and fintech, the area where finance and technology overlap, fintech, payments, analytics. In future, all this CIBIL and all may go away. You might have artificial intelligence making loans.
Analytics, what about pharma and all?
Pharma is excellent. Just look at how well Serum Institute and Bharat Biotech and Dr. Reddy's are doing. Excellent place. But marketing and finance, both are good. But you have to concentrate and work hard and acquire the skills.
Okay. Last call for any more questions.
Sir, is it worth doing PGDM and MBA together? I don't know how to answer this question. What is the difference and how do you do it? So, Mani, can you answer this?
All right. So, basically, it is like this, that we are all PGDMs. At IIM Ahmedabad also, we do PGDM only. All right. And PGDM has equivalence all over the country and abroad. It is only, if you want to do MBA, it is ornamental. That is your wish. Simultaneously along with that. Otherwise, PGDM alone is enough.
Yeah, why spend additional money if PGDM alone is enough? Okay. All right, I think we've answered all questions. Thank you very much. I appreciate your attention.
Okay, let me give the closing word. Thank you. Jerry, for coming and taking your valuable time and speaking to our bright new students. I must say, of course, I have known you for a long time. And I don't know if you remember, I used to sit next to you in the classroom.
Yes.
And I could see whether you had prepared for a class or not. For a case, you were still able to make excellent CP. And I said, yeah, this guy is going to go places. And sure it is. And I think we are all fortunate. I'm speaking from the student side as well as from first timer, that we have a giant amongst our midst. And that speaks not only for your career and your achievements in business, but I think as a lot of you are realizing, Jerry is a walking, talking encyclopedia. And he has deep knowledge. And of course, he's very much a conservative. And today he's considered one of the thought leaders in India. And of course, he has his column and he regularly appears on these publications. Coming to the topic was very relevant. And I'd like to thank Mr. Somani and Mr. Kala for choosing a topic which was both sort of educative as well as relevant and current. And I think we did get a very good view. We got an overview of what's happening in the world and how it relates right down to our students. On the positive side, I think, although Jerry is very much a conservative, I think he took a very positive note saying that the indicators, even no matter how bad the situation is today, the three major indicators indicate that things are going to change around. Just as in human history, there have been issues and problems and civilizations have been able to overcome that. The first of these indicators, of course, the stock markets, which are doing fantastically well. And these are usually indicators that the next 3 years, at least by the time you are going to graduate, are going to be well. And also, this has been a very rich time for startups and businesses in India in spite of COVID. The low interest rates is a further fillip to businesses and all that. And what should students look forward to? Certainly the digital environment, because that is all encompassing. But that is not the last word. There are still traditional values, online learning, interactions. It is something which Fostima very much believes and espouses as well. So I think certainly for me and on behalf of the students, I think we have really had a great session. Again, I would like to thank Mr. Somani and Mr. Kala and all the technical persons behind the scene who have helped put today's event together. Thank you.
There was one more question from Charu Mahajan. Is PGDM considered a PG? Answer is yes. PGDM is as good as any other PG. Don't worry about it.
Anil, final words.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much, Jerry.
Yeah.
Right. And the students are, there'll be a poll which would be conducted by the host. So the students are advised to stay behind and give their views on that, on today's lecture.
Peace.
Thank you. Thank you, Jerry.
Bye.
Jai Hind. Vande Mataram.
Thank you.